Good to see you. Hassan's alive. I've only just seen him. Anahita wasn't with him.
She didn't make it. Killed by Varum.
What? I don't understand.
Artaban, listen. I'm only alive because of her. She took the blade that was meant for me.
What are you saying?
It would take too long to explain, but...
It's the curse of this place, isn't it? I can feel it. The ground shudders, and the air crackles. Sargon, you have to find a way to defeat the cursed magic of this place. Otherwise, we're all lost.
If there's a way, I haven't found it yet. But I will.
How can some things here change so dramatically, and others remain fixed?
I wish I knew. As time flows erratically, I can't help but think there are events that can't be undone.
It makes no sense. Menelaus killed a version of Sargon, yet Sargon kills the only Menelaus.
I'm sure that in another timeline, the fight continues.
Then I wish to be where we immortals are friends again.
Me too, Artaban. Me too.
I'll keep my blade sharp.
Artaban, my sash. I can control it.
Another gift from the Simorgh?
It's a long story. More like it's imbued with Athra. Like my blades and my bow. I can show you.
What a superb display of skill.
I can do something else, too. Watch closely.
Impressive. But such power cannot be imbued in an item in a single lifetime.
Somehow, I feel like I've lived many lives in Mount Carth.
You've done well. I have nothing left to teach you at this point. I have an ancient scroll that was passed down to me by my mentor. Sargon? I think you should have it.
Thank you. wish something forged?
Kahiva, do you remember me?
Of course. My forge will always protect me from time's tricks.
Events have started again. It's as if being trapped in a riddle.
That is not the way to consider it. Events start again, while you continue.
True. I have memories of how things were, and how they could be.
The other mortal longs to ascend to the realm of gods, does he? And you, embracing divine powers for your own. Know this, not even gods can make everything go their way. So, a final word, mortal. I told you Darius had my respect as few mortals do. It wasn't that he was blessed. It was what he did with that blessing. You've earned my respect, Sargon. Do right by it.
Welcome. Welcome.
Do you remember me?
I do. You're the warrior on a somber journey. Promise me we won't lose our city.
I don't know what promises I can make.
Whatever has caused this recent change has caused my amulets to speak to me.
What do they say?
Nothing I can make out yet. It is significant, though. They haven't spoken in over 30 years. Time crystals behave strangely. I haven't seen this before.
It must be the shift in time.
It must be. At the beginning of the curse, timelines shifted often. It's what caused so many poor souls to be hopelessly lost in their own minds.
This was meant to fix things.
Dear, it only means different things get broken.
Could that mean this path is new?
My dear warrior, I honestly don't know. Be careful. There's still much darkness out there.
Hi, Sargon.
Do you still know me?
Don't worry. Not everyone forgets. Not like the mad alchemists. That's why they write it all down. The shift was very strong this time. I wasn't sure what happened, but then I saw your prince,
Hassan.
Alive and well. Very gracious, too. So, you did manage a second chance? The scraggly man still watches you. I don't think time shifted his memories.
It's not always easy to tell with Alkara. Sometimes he makes sense, and sometimes he's helpful.
And sometimes he follows you even when he's ahead of you.
Whatever the timeline, both of you understand Mount Calf much better than I ever will.
I'm glad I showed you how to use memory shards. Whatever happens, don't forget Mount Calf.
I promise I won't.
Phew.
Sargon? When the cursed fog rolled down from the mountains, it stole villages.
Stole them?
Yes. Some disappeared completely, never to be seen.
I think you're messing with me.
I promise that I'm not. I wonder what else the clouds hide. Lend me your Eye of the Wanderer. I'll add the information I've gleaned about this area.
Oh, dear me! I'm stuck! Over here! Can you free me, friend? Get me out of here!
Do you think everyone's destiny intersects with another? That we are all linked?
I hadn't given it much thought. If we are linked, friend, then I need to be honest. I don't see these moon pieces.
Have faith. The true moon shimmers for us both. Shall we carry on? Silence laments the loss of the true moon. Wind and whispers tell us where to find the next moon piece.
refresh something forged.
Here you are again.
Sargon. My father. I see his face. I see myself standing there. My father is dead. Murdered.
I'm sorry, Vara.
And I know of the other one. Sargon, you told me to control my power. And I did. But the other me, he didn't learn. He lost himself.
Each of us has our own path to travel. It's the choices along the journey that decide who we are.
But Sargon, I have no path. I leap across time, and yet I'm still a boy. I'm a traveler who can leap, and yet I'm still stuck in the same place.
Maybe not, Varum. Maybe it's a path you can't see yet. A better one.
Thank you. Yes.
Is done.
Then, was it all worth it?
Only the moon understands the future.
If there's a difference, I can't tell.
You'll see soon. The night sky will reveal our work. The true moon will be there for the world. For your faith in me, I share with you the moon. This token. Now I'll search for the perfect spot to gaze skyward. I hope you will take time to take in the true moon, my friend.
You found me. You found Camia.
The Tower of Silence. I only know of it by legend.
It is ancient, older than legends, by centuries and centuries. The rituals are very secret. All must be done exactly in order. It's the only way to evade the demons and stop them from taking the bodies.
I can't.
Always so brash on the battlefield. Don't hesitate now.
My hand is steady, General. I promise.
A warrior bearing the royal sash? What an honor. I am Meriem, royal architect of the citadel, appointed by King Darius himself. Go on then, you honor me in turn.
It's an honor to meet you. Architect. So the traps, those are your designs?
An admirer. You're welcome. Yes. Puzzles, secrets, technological marvels. Fortifications are my specialty. Must keep the city safe from marauders. Oh, but the city is so much more. The elevator? My idea.
Much of it is very impressive, even if some of it is dangerous.
My true marvel are still in my workshop. I'm sure you'd like to see them.
I might.
Oh, I can't let just anyone in. It has to be someone worthy of the honor. I've hidden treasures around the city. Find all of those, and I'll let you inside my workshop. Wonderful! You won't be disappointed. Actually, you might be if you can't manage. If you fail, just admire the genius that created it. That should make you feel better. Go on. You're off to a good start. My memory is not what it used to be. Have you found all my treasures? Isn't that amazing? I was beginning to think there was no solution.
Now, there was a point where I wondered that too.
I understand that you think some of my designs might be peculiar.
I don't know that it matters if they are. Of course, maybe some of them were meant to kill someone.
Truly my favorites, those.
What I'm trying to say is, the city is full of marvels the world has never seen.
I knew it! A gift waits for you in my workshop. Go on. My memories return. King Darius. 30 years since he's been gone. I hope I've honored his vision. I wonder, though, if my work will be forgotten.
The king had a vision for the greatness of the citadel to remain across the ages. To me, he appointed the right person. He'd be impressed with the technological marvels.
You know? You've given me a great gift.
By solving your puzzles?
Yes, but not only that. The real gift you gave me is that you took the time to interact with my work. You've acknowledged my life's dedication. For that, I will tell you a secret resonating through the buildings.
And what is it telling you?
The Samor lives. May you find purpose on your journey.
Sargon.
Made another discovery?
Shh. King Darius, King of Kings, rests within the Tower of Silence. Here, many kings and queens are brought to rest. Even the gods come to pay their respects.
This place towers over the city.
The king wanted the city built near the gods. Legend says, at the very top of the highest mountain, you can see into the past.
Sometimes I think you tease me with your tales. Until next time.
Next time. Lend me your Eye of the Wanderer. I'll add the information I've gleaned about this area.
Thank you. Father, 30 years have passed, and I'm still lost. I seek your guidance. I wish I knew your hardships of being a righteous king. I wish I had your courage. I hope I can be half the king you were. May you hear me and see me as I ascend. Sargon. Have you come to pay your respects?
I'm here for you, Varan.
Kings don't have friends, and you won't give me your powers. Where does that leave us?
We're always in each other's path.
Then I'm sure you will find me again.
Sister!
resistance! Darius, I know what happened to you and to Varum. What Tamiris did, it was unspeakable.
Save this world. Save my son.
How do I save him? Have mercy on your soul, King Darius.
Sargon, the corruption of this place is consuming you.
Not this place, Nate. It's the powers. They're not meant for mere mortals.
Gifts that are also a curse. Leave them then.
I have no choice. How else can I face Varum? It's the only way to end this. I just realized. For all the different paths of Sargon, this must be the single path we'll share. I have no choice. Talk about the path.
What is mine?
One's path is like the sacred cypress of Abaku. A single stem, one life, has brought you to this sunrise. Along your path, the past has already been carved. It's unique. Now a thousand branches are ahead of you. And on every branch, a thousand fruits. And in every fruit, a thousand seeds. One of these seeds will be your path.
I've met you before, but much younger. Even held you in my arms. Yes, yes, I did.
You must have me confused with someone else.
But it was you, that spark in your eye. I'm sure of it, and you seem perfect for my challenge.
Sure. Were you expecting me?
Anyone passing by, really. A perfect place to issue a challenge, don't you think? I'll release three magical bells, you see. High above, where no one can reach except. It takes patience, awareness of patterns, and ingenuity. Maybe. There's no one skilled enough for this. Never mind.
I survived Mount Carth. Try me.
Impressive. If you do this, I'll throw in a reward too. Well, are you skilled enough? Excellent. Indeed. Show just how capable you are, young one. Ready? All three magical bells. Patience, awareness, ingenuity. And remember, you have what it takes. Do you have enough? That's the question.
Told you I was skilled.
So you did. And a great demonstration at that. All three. Hand them over. You've earned a sense of accomplishment. And then some. Exiled. Yes. Punishment for speaking the truth. I used to be someone important in Persepolis. A physician, too. That was another life. Maybe another soul is willing to undertake the challenge.
You're just waiting until someone passes by.
Patience, young one. It's all I have. Patience. That's all I have.
I do admire you, Sargon. You don't need Artaban or Nade's help to get here.
So the summit of Mount Carf is where it will all play out.
Considering what Varum is after, he should be in the Hall of Divination by now.
I must stop him before he absorbs the heart of the Simorgh.
And that power in the wrong hands could destroy Persia.
The Simorgh's feathers. I have some of them. I know they don't belong to someone like me.
Bloodline is not everything.
It's your actions that matter.
And look how Varum changed. You must defeat him, Sargon.
I'll try to save him first. It may be the last time we meet.
Sargon, bravery is what makes you immortal.
The fate of Persia depends on you.
Nait, Artaban, I have to fight Varum.
We know, Sargon. We know.